New details tonight of what is shaping up as the largest overhaul of higher education in a generation. The university's Accord final report, launched in Bankstown, recommending more places for low and middle income students.
On Smart Street, hoping to make the streets a little smarter.
Universities change lives if they're managed well, and universities can change nations.
Among the recommendations, 80% of Australians receive university or higher level technical qualifications by 2050, with more than 1 million extra Commonwealth supported places targeting areas of national skill shortages while making help payments easier to get and pay off.
I've made it pretty clear that my priority is helping more kids from the outer suburbs and the regions, more kids from poor families get a crack at university.
The review also wants more free bridging courses for students that don't initially qualify for uni, and introducing payments for previously unpaid work placement training in nursing, care and teaching.
So that they can fill those jobs, drive that economy, as well as provide a good quality of life for themselves and their families.
But this would cost many billions of dollars to deliver, and we are certainly concerned that the government has really raised expectations.
Business and science groups have welcomed the report, while universities support it but are wary of costs, with suggestions tonight wealthy unis should help poorer ones.
I believe this is the most important contribution to tertiary education for decades.
This doesn't come for free. So that'll be a challenge for government in terms of how it closes the circle.
This is one of three reviews into Australia's education sector. The government believing longer term reform can lead to a longer time in power.
The agreement I strike this year and the election that we fight next year will determine the future of public education.
The report tonight with the government, the first changes will be included in the budget in May. Charles Croucher, Nine News.
OK, let's bring in Nine's political editor, Charles Croucher. Charles, good evening. Despite victories in the parliament, there's trouble in the polls tonight for the government.
Evening, Pete. Yes, in an exclusive poll just released by Resolve Political Monitor to our colleagues at the Sydney Morning Herald and The Age, it shows a continued decline of the government standings. The coalition now leads Labor on primary votes, 37 to 34. This is the first time since the last election that the opposition has led the primary vote in this poll. Anthony Albanese is still the preferred Prime Minister, leading 39-32, but that lead is just a quarter of the lead the Prime Minister held in May last year. And these numbers are important, Pete, because this time next week we'll know the result of the crucial by-election in Dunkley.
All right, Charles, thank you.